Hi guys, Alex Hanna Racing here. As I promised, I am going to do some Dover Xfinity cars. And I just joined the race that I thought, oh, there won't be a lot of people in it. I'll probably do really good on it. And if you just look at the bottom right, that's qualifying. That's how close the field is. I ran a 24-0. And I'm starting 7th. This is a bunch of good guys. I have about a 4,000 I rating. I'm sure all these guys have decent I ratings as well. I'm gonna say is whoever wins this race probably deserves to win it.
Going green. Pace car is in. Green, green, green.
Hey, boss. But I guess we're just gonna have to let this race play out. Not wreck, avoid any wrecks that are gonna happen.
Outside. Keep low. Stay low. Stay low.
Side lane is pretty good.
Still there.
They can punch the guy down like what's being done to me. Oh, that's blink.
Clear outside. Car outside. Clear.
Yeah, but if you can pinch a guy down, it's like you can really hold the guy behind you. I'm just sketchy. This is real sketchy up ahead. This is not exactly when you see this kind of racing. Guys getting loose off the corners. You can tell they're pushing. And they're taking it 3 wide at Dover. Man, oh man, that's not gonna work. Got this guy. Huge run on me.
Inside. Stay high.
Oh, that's...
Keep high.
I'm gonna have to lift because this guy's...
Still there.
Lost his momentum.
Keep high.
Huge line of cars. I need to get to the bottom.
Hold your line.
Tire wear is probably going to play a factor. I don't know how much of it, though. It's going to happen on a short run. You got loose. That's what I needed. He's gonna get pressure behind. I'm gonna be able to focus on the 6th quarter. It's 11 cars. It's a really bad connection. I'm definitely gonna have to be careful around them. Making sure that, you know, we don't netcode and take each other out that way, because that really sucks when that happens. It's gonna roll into the corner. I don't want to drive in there hard when I don't really necessarily have to. That's how you can really save tires. And either, you know, the truck's the Xfinity or the cup car. It's 50 laps, so it's not really a super long race. Cautions are definitely on, but this, no one has wrecked yet, which is a miracle for B-Fix. Or actually for anything in iRacing. how good of a line will be the outside for passing? In fact, that's probably where I'm going to have to go. It's like everyone's sort of moving up another lane up the track and sort of diamonding with the exit. Everyone's getting squirrely. This is probably when a caution comes out. Wouldn't mind one as long as I'm not in it. My car is definitely faster than me, but it's definitely gotta pass me. These people. Really hope it doesn't go green all the way, because I have not been saving tires. I've been racing people hard. Usually they are cautions. Starting to get on the loose myself. Ooh. Definitely not go any rush wall here. You need as much downforce as you can. Car's right tight enough as it is. You're gonna get a pass up ahead. This is where I could possibly get a spot out of this. Definitely feel the tightness coming on. Battling going out behind me, that should allow me to focus on the two up ahead.
Inside.
That's what I needed, that's what I needed. I'm on the outside.
Still there. Stay high.
We're not clear!
They're inside.
That was too close. Killed all my momentum. Still going straight, that's all that matters. So gonna be going at it again. Start racing each other for this long, you start to wonder when the bumper is gonna get used. Don't see it coming. Right now. Ooh.
Car outside. They're outside.
Well, that completely compromised my corner.
Car inside.
Still gonna hold on.
Clear.
Whew. This is why I love racing. It's just close moments like that where you're just on edge, never really safe. Just gotta concentrate, just be in the zone. I think he's still driving. Six cars definitely missing the apex. You know, this is oval, you've really still gotta hit your marks. Right now I just think the line is a little bit lower than what he's running. Oh man. Ah, too much throttle. Try to pounce before the six car was in my sights. Check where the leader is, but I'm sure he's probably long gone from what I can actually view. Reeling back.
Okay, we're halfway to the finish.
Halfway, he's in the wall. The car is definitely damaged. It's not gonna drive right.
Outside.
That's what I mean.
They're outside.
You gotta be ready for anything. That could happen. If you're not prepared, you're causing a huge wreck. Well, now I got a gap. Just focus ahead, really. Maybe these guys killed their tires or something. I can get up there. Get one or two of them. Got like 20 laps to go. Plenty of time for something to happen. Maybe even a caution, that's kind of what I need now, but I kind of don't want one because, well, I have a decent track position all by myself. Relatively safe from carnage. Now I had some good racing, shame that it ended like that. I think I definitely have to arc the corner more. I'm driving it in there too low. Everyone around me is kind of running similar lap times. But yeah, gotta love this Xfinity car and old tires. I don't think I've told my subscribers yet on YouTube, but this last season, or actually last year, towards the end of it, I joined a league that ran a cup and truck, and I enjoyed it. I was just in the trucks, and you know, I did a good job there, and they promoted me to the Cup Series, and they made the Truck Series a National Series, or a Can-Am car. Oh, this is...
Go high.
That's top five? No caution. No caution. What does I want to hear? But,
you're in fifth.
Yes, we are in fifth, but I'm going to be doing that. It's going to be Friday night, Saturday night. I don't know if I'm going to live stream it or if I'm just going to like record it like what I'm doing now. Because if the Xfinity car in that series is anything like what it is and going to be what I'm driving now, I'm going to have last Friday nights. Saturday nights as well. But I'm in there for the Xfinity car. Kind of nowhere on this track right now, which is good. It's gonna focus on my line, on not spinning out. Hopefully everyone else focused on not spinning out. Nothing happens. Got some lap cars up ahead. Hopefully they don't pose an issue. Caution comes out, hopefully it's within 5 laps to go. If it does, iRacing does not do overtime at all, that'd be the end of the race. Yeah, this lap car seems to be letting everyone by, which is kind of low. Also, if I can finish here, hopefully I didn't just stick myself there, but if I can finish where I am now, I'm not that far from 4,000 iRating. I was 4,000 iRating about a year or so ago, then I had some internet issues, kept on dropping up every race I joined, and that fell.
10 laps left.
So hopefully this will put me back up to 4,000, I reckon. He's gonna buy, what's he gonna do? He's just gonna let me buy.
Car outside.
That'll drift up and kill him.
Still there.
He's fast. Yeah, look ahead now. Only need to get through 2 more laps and France will be done. Rio. So another thing to note, iRacing is going to be doing they're going to be doing a feeder series into the Pro Series, which basically, if anyone who doesn't actually really watch iRacing, basically you have the premier peak antifreeze series that has a feeder series called the Pro Series, and that's, you know, like in November, when after all that's done, and that, you know, guys from that points their way into the peak series, and basically this the Xfinity car is going to become the series that you race to get into the Pro Series, which definitely is going to make it fun. I don't know anything about setups, but if I did, I think I'd have a decent shot of making it. Let's see some of these people here. Really clean group of guys. This is, races like these are a rarity in iRacing, but man, really fun. As long as you don't wreck yourself at the end of a run. Just gonna limp her home, no need to race hard. Not racing anybody.
Two laps to go.
Two to go.
White flag, one to go.
Only gonna have to worry about stuff for about 25 more seconds. Oh, he's wrecking. Gotta avoid. He's gonna come up the track. He's probably gonna gain momentum before I don't think I'm able to get to him. He's just out of sight. I don't know what's going on with him. He just stops. Well, P4. I'll take that. Woo! How far did I finish behind the leader?
Second flag.
9 seconds. Jeez, Colson.
Great job, driver.
Checked out. I wasn't that far behind second and third, though. What a race. Anyways. Hope you guys enjoyed this race. I definitely enjoyed racing it. I'll see you in the next video, guys.